Richard Poulden from PCGE is with me in the studio. Richard, nice to see you. Welcome on.
Good morning, Andrew. Thank you.
It's been a busy, and some might say challenging, 6 to 12 months for the company. Of course, you had the disposal of CPDC. We'll get to that in a moment. You also, we saw the chief executive, Nick Bryant, leave around about March.
Well, Nick was actually dismissed.
Right.
So that's an important difference. Unfortunately, we can't really go into the reasons for that because we've got an employment tribunal claim against the company, me, and Michael Minnelli.
Right.
The two of us personally. So we'll just have to see how that plays out.
I spoke a moment ago about CPDC. A bit of a relief to have that behind you?
Well, you said a challenging 6 or 18 months or 12 months or whatever. I would say it was an insanely problematic, very stressful 12 months, actually. Unwinding the CPDC transaction was extremely complex, and definitely I have to pay tribute to Allenby, our Nomad, who helped, and also, truthfully, to AIM, because they come in for a lot of criticism of being bureaucratic and so on, but they've been tremendous in helping with the restructuring of PCG, taking a very commercial view of what we were trying to do, and that's been very helpful.
Just on that point, before we talk about what might be in the pipeline coming up, I know that you've recently changed your year end from the end of December to the end of March. What was behind that?
Yes, we did that. Now, we moved the year end so that the entire disposal of CPDC was contained within the period of the accounts. If we'd actually stuck to the original 31st December year end, because we only actually, although we signed the agreement to get rid of CPDC on the 29th of December, it wasn't actually completed until into the following year. So what that change of year end enabled us to do is give a clear picture to investors of what the company will look like going forward. So that although we have qualifications in the accounts, those relate only to CPDC. The holding company accounts by the statutory auditor are completely unqualified.
Very good. I know you've recently raised quite a bit of cash, £1 million.
Mm-hmm.
Interestingly, with no public business plan.
Well, that's actually correct, yes, Andrew. We've raised a fair amount of money during the year. You've seen the various placings we've done following the CPDC disposal. I think there's an element there of people not actually thinking we were going to get it done. And so once we did get it done, then there's been a lot of interest in PCGE. But Riverfort is particularly significant because they have access to a lot of money. They are capable of providing debt as well as equity, mm-hmm. which is very important from a structuring point of view. And they're also prepared to look at funding at a project level, as well as the holding company level. So it's a very powerful combination that we've got there. But you are absolutely right. They have no business plan at all. They're not insiders.
Well, I don't want to labor the point, but the fact that they have provided the cash, have they got a possible idea of what might be in the pipeline here?
No. That would make them insiders.
It certainly would.
and so they don't.
Well, speaking of what's on the horizon, I know you've said you're looking at a number of opportunities, a number of avenues for potential projects, potential acquisitions. What would you deem as a good project? What would you like to see?
Well, I think the current group in PCGE have all worked with me in restructuring deals. I mean, we took Sirius from being a bust copper explorer to being a potash company. Although it's both natural resources, there's absolutely no connection between the two. And truthfully, Wishbone was really a fairly ho-hum, AIM-listed gold explorer, but now it's got a major gold trading business operating in three continents, and that's completely different from drilling holes in the ground. So really, we will look at any deal that makes sense. Now, obviously, you want to look at sectors that are interesting from the point of view of the world economy. So that might be environmental deals. It might be renewable energy deals. It might be energy storage, which anyone who's followed any of my musings and writings knows is one of my particular hobby horses. So We are looking at a broad range of potential transactions.
Have you got a rough idea when you'd like to see one done?
By 4 p.m. today? No. We need to crack on. Now that we've got the accounts out of the way, because that was the real obstacle to actually moving forward on any of these deals, we had to get that done, sorted, and move on to the next stage. We've got plenty of cash. I think I would flag up to any shareholders out there that almost certainly whatever we do will be deemed to be a reverse, whether it is according to the class tests or not.
Right.
Because a new business coming in, AIM are going to want a full readmission document. And obviously we will try and do that as quickly as possible, but they should be prepared for that.
Very good, Richard. I suppose just a final word. It's been a bit of a roller coaster, some might say, for shareholders. Mm-hmm. You sympathise the journey they've been on over the last 6 to 12 months?
I've been on it with them. Absolutely. I'm a major shareholder as well.
Right. So onwards and upwards.
Onwards and upwards, definitely. But, a big thank you to everyone who has supported the restructuring. Big thank you to the institutions who have come in and the retail investors who've come in on the back of the various placings. Thanks for your confidence. We will aim to please.
Very nice, Richard. Look forward to hearing further updates from you as well. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks a lot, Andrew. Appreciate it.